Access have won quite a few ARIAs in their impressive 40-year run, and the band was on hand last night as the Aussie music industry celebrated the best of the past 12 months. Scott Tweedie caught up with two of the stars from In Excess, and they shared their favourite ARIA moments.
Congratulations, 40 years.
Yeah.
30 years of Kick as well. Tonight's got to be a bit of a celebration. The celebration's been going for a little while now. Yeah. Remember that masquerade party, but how's it feeling to be back at the ARIA?
It's good, you know. I mean, we just did a flyby then and just looked at the enormity of the whole red carpet scene and just how it's grown since the inception of the first ARIAs, which were not public. And we've seen how much the Australians, you know, music scene has boomed and blossomed. Yeah, so it's really great to be here and to see so many different acts, the diversity of acts and lots of talent and people ready to have a good time.
It's always an adventure. Where do you keep all your ARIA awards?
Well, let me tell you a story.
A long time ago, we had a management company, and what happened was, is often with a lot of the award shows, we got, you know, Brit Awards, Countdown Awards, ARIA Awards, MTV Awards, Grammy nominations. Collectively, we didn't have copies of each award each, and so at one point it was said, okay, we're gathering up all the awards, and we're going to duplicate them so that you all have one of every award. And then that was the last we ever saw of them.
I only laughed at your question because I recently moved house. I don't know where anything is. Yeah. So I laugh because I wish I knew where a whole lot more than just my awards, but I know they're
underwear. He's lost his underwear.
I lost my mind. But yeah, the awards are in a box deep in a container somewhere. But hey, you know, we still know what went on and it means a lot.
Tonight you're presenting Best Australian Live Act. Who's some of the best Australian live acts you've seen over the years?
In Excess.
They're awesome, yeah.
Powderfinger, I always thought were really a really awesome live act. So many. I mean, that was the great thing about Australian acts versus overseas acts was that we all knew how to play live, you know, and especially the 80s kind of bands, because there was that whole pub scene and we all used to play every night, you know, Mental as Anything, the Angels, you know, Midnight Oil. They are all so powerful live because we all used to play gigs every night of the week.
There's a huge scene going on.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was just a rotation of all these acts. And you know, we were lucky because there's a lot more venues than there are now in Australia. Not the one to get political or anything, but I mean, it's really easy to say, hey, get out there and, you know, go and perform play live. But it's like, well, good luck trying to find someone to play. But that's what we need, is more places to play.
Darryl Braithwaite joins you guys in the ARIA Hall of Fame. If you took a guess at what song he's going to perform, what do you think it would be?
Well, you know, I was hoping it would be something from Sherbet. Because I used to go and see Sherbet when I was a kid in the 70s.
I was too young.
Yeah, John was too young. But I used to go with Tim, actually, John's eldest brother. We used to go to concerts to see bands like Hush and Sherbet and Billy Thorpe and Lobby Lloyd and the Colored Balls and all these amazing 70s acts that were just out there, you know. Yeah. But I look at, you know, it's probably going to be Horses. I mean, Horses for Courses for Dazzler.
Tweedie joined us now, and Scott, your poor little princess. Are you okay?
You know what they say in TV, don't work with kids, animals, or come to a live TV show after an award show. So I made it on time. I'm here to tell you what happened at the ARIA.
Gatorade has really taken a pounding this morning.
That is not correct, that you were in bed at 8:30, is that right?
They're rumours. Rock and roll, baby. I was out late all night. Depends who's asking.
Yeah, okay? Exactly. Yeah. Now, Darryl Braithwaite. Oh, Horses. Surely we've just been having a debate. That's the best song ever.
No, as the days go by.
I don't want to get into this argument, but name one RSL or pub that Darryl Braithwaite hasn't played at in
Mudgee
Australia.
Mudgee RSL.
I reckon he has. Five times. That circus gone round and round. But no, last night was a great night. Look, obviously, because it was such a momentous occasion, Guy Sebastian, Vera Blue got up with him and they did a bit of a modern twist on a classic song.
Oh. You missed me, but I caught
you out. How's that? In 1968, I sang along with a band called Semi Lilith. And it was there when Clive Shakespeare and Bruce Worrell came along to see one of the gigs, and they asked me to join a band called Sherbet. Looking back, the Sherbet experience was unbelievable. After Sherbet called it quits, I was a little lost. I took to playing the clubs with a friend of mine, the late Johnny Dick, but it wasn't satisfying. I stopped playing music, but needed to work. So I had to go on the dole. After about 6 weeks, they found me a job at the Sunbury Council, working on the roads for 10 weeks. It was there that I realised I had to try and make music again in some way. In 1987, I remember sitting in my car at St Kilda when Barry Bissell on Fox SM announced a new song that he was going to play. And he gave it a big rap, and it was As the Days Go By. 50 years later, as I'm standing here, my love for music and playing live is still the same as it was when I started out.
Did you know the first concert I ever went to, and Daryl Braithwaite was speaking about it then, was a fundraising concert for friends of Daryl Braithwaite when he was broke and literally lost the shirt off his back. And it was the first concert I ever went to at Melbourne Tennis Centre, and Jimmy Barnes was there with all his mates, Josh Frydenberg and all
is
those.
Is this pre or post horses?
This is pre-horses. This is way pre-horses. This is before you were born, Scotty.
I was living around.
Anyway.
The good old days, Joe. Right, the good old days. Yeah.
And Barry Bissell got a mention. I remember making mixtapes to
the top
Barry.
40 sitting there ready to hit the play and record.
Do you know what tapes are, Scotty?
Yeah, I do. Okay. A side, B side. Put the tape on there so you can't tape over your cassettes.
That's right.
I just snuck in there.
Remember when the highest technology that music could ever accomplish was high-speed dubbing?
Yes.
Now, the ARIAs isn't about the radio, FM radio. Crowd, Scotty, of course, which I was a trailblazer in myself as well. Casey Chambers and Paul Kelly were big winners.
Yeah, Paul Kelly brought the house down. He did his classic Dumb Things, which everyone went wild for. He took out for the third time Best Male Artist and also Best Adult Contemporary Album for Life is Fine. Casey Chambers took out Best Country Album. When she came up on stage, though, she said earlier in the day she was actually just picking out knits out of her daughter poet's hair. So how's that for a day for Casey Chambers? An aria and knits.
Life is fantastic. Yes, that's what happens sometimes. My hair's itchy as I think about it.
Now, Harry Styles, though, I didn't even know he was in the country, but he's won an aria.
Come on. Of course he's in the country. You've got to just see where all the teen girls are flocking to, and that's where Harry Styles is. He's a stylish man, but everyone was actually blowing up, not about his suit, not about his singing, about his shoes. Ooh. The fans were quick and onto these shoes. I didn't know these existed, but it's a half clog looking half croc shoe, and they hit to Twitter straight away, and they were some of the comments that came up on Twitter were a classic from his fans. Burn these shoes, one girl said. Another girl was pretty much on, I'm loving the outfit, but what are these shoes? And but seriously, they are the ugliest shoes Harry has ever worn.
I love how that fan's so intense that she knows every pair of shoes that Harry has ever worn. Yeah, how these fit into the Harry shoe pantheon.
So don't they have a back part? Is that what they are, like clogs?
No, they actually had a heel as well. So when he was performing, but look, Harry Styles, he's such a stylish man. Yes, in 3 years, I'll be wearing it.
Yeah.
In 5 years, Joe will be wearing it.
So that, 10.
Hang on, wait, that was a burn, wasn't it?
Two burns, actually.
Ladies and gentlemen, drop the mic. I'm out of here.
Before you go, what's happening on the loop this weekend?
Well, yeah, on the loop this weekend, we're going to do a full wrap-up of the ARIAs and the ARIAs red carpet action as well. We're going to be talking about some artists that you guys... Do you know Illy?
No, not if he's called.
Some artists that people might not know, but also we do a 90s power hour at the end of the show as well. So a lot of fun. 9 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Saturday mornings, Channel 11. That's where you can find me, and my hangover should be done by then.
Yeah. You're so young and hip, aren't you? Yeah.